Stockwell and Kim Cattrall star in Palais Royal. It's the 50s, and things are happening at the Palais Royal, especially for a young man who has lost his heart to the wrong girl. A movie special, Sunday. David Suzuki and The Nature of Things present a film on the hyena, next.
This is it. Your bottle, General. Los Alamos. What do you think?
Seems ideal. I wish I could say the same for you.
Sir?
Well, you tell me a lot of things, Robert, but you didn't tell me you were a rat.
I'm not.
Your wife's former husband fought in Spain with the communists. Your ex-fiancé, your brother, several of your students are card-carrying members of the party.
Oh, come on!
You attended cell meetings? I could go on.
Don't you remember how black and white things were in the 30s? The Depression, misery, poverty. I was in love with this girl. She was in love with the cause. I was never a member of the party.
What are your politics?
I believe in my country.
Washington has advised me not to give you any responsibility.
Look. I've worked with the best minds in science. Men who've made discoveries. They won Nobel Prizes. They...
Yeah. What? What? That bothers you? Washington tells me you're some kind of Hindu mystic.
I know Sanskrit. That doesn't make me a Hindu mystic.
I kill a rat and that bothers you? What are you gonna make of a bomb?
I'm a scientist, not a politician.
Doesn't work.
Then it doesn't work.
Would you reassure me, for God's sake?
Well, it could blow up.
Possible, of course. Then the general would have all the proof he needs.
Remove bars. Four.
Removing
and
four.
12.
By 12.
Four by 12.
And 12, yes.
To provoke the chain reaction is one thing, Mr. Greenwald. To control it could be quite another. In the pails is a neutron-absorbent liquid cadmium. If the atomic fire, shall we say, surpasses our expectations, they will empty their buckets.
The suicide squad. The neutron flux going through the graphite increases as he removes the cadmium rods.
12 removed.
Number 12 removed.
Well, as more neutrons strike uranium, more atoms explode.
More atoms explode into what?
Remove half of five.
Five to half.
And eight.
Five half.
And half of eight.
Half eight.
Watch the counters.
Five and eight.
What's happening?
Shh.
Five and eight.
Is it working?
Shh.
East road 7, 15 centimeters.
7, 15 centimeters. Seven back 15.
Pull it back. Another 10 centimeters.
Another 10 centimeters back.
In the presence of a chain reaction which is continuous and sustained. We just entered the nuclear age.
It works.
Send a telegraphic code for the president.
Immediately.
Boys in a treehouse.
I knew everything Enrico was doing until now.
Until they really began to do it.
Hmm.
I know what I'm celebrating.
What?
A little American.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
Yes?
Yes.
Does Edward know?
Oh, yeah. We had breakfast together last month, and now he's going away.
Why?
I don't know.
Where's Leo?
Over there.
Hmm.
Trying to call Trudy.
Hmm?
It's a good relationship, huh?
Why? He hasn't seen Trudy for 2 years.
Love stripped is the essential. Hello. How are you? Do you exist?
Oh, it's wonderful.
Denver, Colorado. Think of it, Edward. It's not just a weapon anymore.
Yes.
It's Vistas. A new world of energy. University hospital. Dr. Gertrude Weiss. Yes, yes. I'll wait. Do you realize we have in this one morning changed the world forever? Yes, I'll wait.
Marriage implies no secrets, Hans.
Yes, but marriage also implies... Rose, you are the most persistent, the most persuasive wife I've got.
Hmm.
Now, you really want to know what we've been working on?
Yeah.
Uranium-235 plus one. Neutron equals barium-144 plus krypton-90 plus 2 neutrons plus 200 MeV. Now you know as much as I do.
I write you about what I'm doing.
Hello, Trudy.
What should I write you about? Please, Edward. Trudel, listen to me.
My Trudy.
The fact that I choose to write you about what I think should tell you that I care about you.
Could I get you?
Leo should have this project. He's been with these ideas for 10 years.
Edward, you might choose Leo to invent a better banana, but would you seriously choose him to run your store?
Who else is Oppenheimer recruiting?
Everybody he can get.
Mm. Well, I'm sure Dr. Oppenheimer would impress.
Equipment, stupid!
Oh, we are right.
Robert Oppenheimer's welcoming committee. We are Robert Oppenheimer's welcoming committee.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. Hello, Johnny.
Welcome to Post Office Box 1663.
This is a concentration camp here.
And you are here to concentrate, my dear.
This is a restricted area. You are not allowed to talk science. Prepare your papers for the gate.
Janosch. Paul Volta.
Mark it up,
mark
it up.
Chuck Merkel.
No ball on
the English!
Scheisskopf.
How much do we have to
name
over here, huh? We don't have time?
Kistyakovsky. And this is Jacques Cartier.
Jesus, never
thanks.
God, they're all foreigners.
How do you spell that?
Slutzin. S-L-O-T-E-N. Louis Slutzin.
Yeah.
I'm from Winnipeg.
Thanks.
Please five.
Where?
Canada.
Hey, General. An escort to our apartments, please.
Sir.
Get
sir,
these
run
guys
away,
to
sir.
The tents. Sober them up.
Yes, Mr. MP.
Jeez.
Finally happening, Edward. We're gonna do it. We have the brain power here to accomplish anything.
We could do wonderful things. We could do things much greater than just make a lump of uranium explode. That, for example. Fusion. To work with hydrogen. To create the power. Something truly interesting, truly magnificent. It's possible, you know, the brain power to accomplish anything, Robert. Science may never again have the opportunity that we have now. Look at it. Beyond that, what could this wonderful brain do? Imagine it. What could be done?
We're here to work with fission. Come on, we'll be late for breakfast.
You don't seriously believe that we are all going to wear uniforms?
Definitely not. We are not. That is where we draw the line. Absolutely
not wear a uniform.
Yes.
No, definitely not. No.
Let Dr. Oppenheimer talk.
Thank you, Kisty.
And let me sleep. I would only request that since there is no water here, and since brushing your teeth with Coca-Cola is sticky,
yes, right.
Could we please import some scotch?
Okay. About the uniforms, I agree. And I'll talk to General Groves about it tomorrow.
How long do we have to live like Boy Scouts?
Well, we're building barracks as fast as we can.
Barracks!
Try to be patient. Living conditions are bound to improve, and your wives and children will be here soon.
Yes, but what about our working conditions? We must be allowed to talk amongst each other, to talk to other departments, right?
I agree. We can't work like this.
Look, for the first time, scientists have been given all the money, all the material, and all the manpower we could ever need. I think that under the circumstances, we can put up with a few security regulations. Damn it, you've got to accept reality. We're working for the army now. This is war. Our first order of business, very important. The words bomb, uranium, plutonium are strictly forbidden. We are the only ones to know what goes on here. Nobody else. No technicians, no secretaries, no guards, not even your wives and kids when they finally do get here. Top secret. Is that clear?
Yes.
Okay. While our colleagues in Chicago and in California concentrate on making our, jam, we make the jar. This monster here is our first order of priority and our first problem. Basically, we have a cannon. On one side, fissible material. On the other side, a combustion chamber. Here, a projectile, also of fissible material. Classic detonation of explosives, Dr. Kistiakovsky.
Huh?
And critical mass.
Very exciting. Very, very.
Show me your passes. Your pass?
Ta-da.
Hi.
Hi, guys.
Hi, Louis.
Hey, they've sent us the parts for the new electric calculator. Seems like a real gazelle.
Good. Put us all out of work.
Some hotshot arrives tomorrow to assemble it.
I'm going to do it myself and drive him nuts.
Louis.
Careful.
But then, no, bracket here, bracket minus X.
For the 94 plutonium. And possibly we'd have a premature explosion, yeah? Yep. Niedermeyer's idea for the 94 is to make it a round, hollow sphere. We pack explosives all around it and attain critical mass by implosion.
That's so much more elegant.
But it will take a mountain of calculation.
And the Russian dynamiter's genius.
Edward?
You know what Hoppy thinks about this?
The cannon won't work with plutonium.
The cannon is our priority. If we need something else for the plutonium, we'll work on it after the cannon, right? But this is beautiful. This is elegant. Edward, it's not because I'm in charge of the department, but... Don't make this difficult. You know what Oppenheimer wants. So let's just do what we are asked to do.
America's leading meat company, Oscar Mayer, got together with Kraft, Canada's leading cheesemaker.
Let's do lunch.
A delicious meeting of the minds. Oscar Mayer Lunchables. Lunch combinations from Kraft. Prepared meat, processed cheese, and crisp crackers.
Very nice. Very nice.
Freshness sealed and ready to eat. Lunchables, the portable feast from Kraft and Oscar Mayer.
Mmm. You must have won every ribbon at the county fair.
Mmm. You don't bake. You create.
Mmm. Melting your mouth.
Oh, what is your secret?
I'd crawl 3,000 miles for another slice.
Guarda la crema. Mmm.
How do you do it?
Lactantia. With butter still slowly churned using only fresh, rich cream. Nobody butters you up better.
Pizza Hut presents
Supreme Pan Pizza.
The original Supreme Pan Pizza for $10.99.
Come into Pizza Hut.
Get it while it's hot.
Supreme and nothing but.
With Pizza Hut's original Supreme Pan Pizza, you always get six delicious, fresh, mouth-watering toppings.
Pizza Hut.
Only at Pizza Hut.
The supreme choice from Pizza Hut.
And only $10.99 for a medium Supreme Pan Pizza.
Pizza Hut.
Oh, yeah.
Miss Steinberg's promotion of the new generation of black and white dishes from Corningware. Collect your cash register tapes and or Corningware bonus dollars from Steinberg and get discounts of up to 50% in supermarket exclusively at Steinberg.
You can buy a car and spend your vacation in it. Or you can buy a Saturn car and spend what you save on a real vacation. Saturn. We've reinvented the automobile.
How long is it going to take, Kisti?
Even when Troika stops, still go forward.
Russian Trover.
Implosion or explosion, it's nitroglycerin. After that, it's just a matter of which way you want the shock waves to go.
But you agree. We should be working on implosion now.
Maybe, maybe.
This is not vodka. I'm Queen Anastasia!
Don't let Groves get wind of this, or he'll send you to Stalingrad.
And now, the mass production!
Yeah. Hey, new women have just arrived.
Come on, Kisti. Fill it up.
Get a piano?
I told Groves that I couldn't think without one. This arrived next morning. The space between our ears is a source of constant concern to the general.
If you can have a piano, I want a washing machine.
No.
I don't want to spend my entire days washing in lab coats and cleaning desert sand out of your socks.
This could be a wonderful place.
Scientifically? Or residentially?
Have you heard from Leo?
I saw him a few times in Washington. He's always going someplace. He's sort of your general's pet wizard.
Tennessee, Oak Ridge, top secret. They shoot husbands for that.
So what's the problem, Leo?
You know, the temperatures are still much too high, Green One. We have to do something about this.
Yes, look, over here,
we take a look. The situation must be improved.
Well, we'll fix it, Leo.
Hello, Herbert.
Now, let's check it.
Now, come over here. Look at this. Still very much too high.
How's it going, Tiff?
Cut it out.
Eye on the dial, hon. Keep the needle from passing this level, Mary.
And what will happen if they do pass it?
Well, your pants will fall down.
Ha ha.
Oh, damn it. Settle down, girls. Settle down.
All right, back to your positions, please.
Shouldn't we wait for the general? Mr.
No,
Groves.
No, no, try a test first.
All right. We're going to apply power.
Okay, everybody, we're going to go.
Fantastic. 50,000 workers housed in the city built from scratch.
It used to be so pretty around here.
You got the chocolates?
Mm-hmm.
It's a whole industrial civilization.
Yesterday it was virgin land. Today it's lit up like a Christmas tree. Where the heck is it? Stop the car.
Geniuses.
Haven't you ever heard of the invention of the flashlight?
Mm-hmm. The Army sent thousands of flashlights. No batteries.
Typical. I come here to Oak Ridge, expecting you to be in full production. What do I get here? What, midnight mass?
This was our first try.
I've given you 40,000 tons silver to put in that machine, Lawrence. You know what I had to go through to get that from Treasury, 40,000 tons? Now, what do you got to show for it?
We found the problem.
It'll be another 100 million to repair it, I suppose.
A little electricity will suffice.
I'd like to speak to you gentlemen privately. There is not one single gram of uranium in this place. Now, your colleagues at Los Alamos are working miracles. But we cannot assemble a weapon without your powder.
The diffusion of the gas. The filters don't work. We've come up with another type that seems efficient, but they're made by hand.
We'll make them by hand.
We'll need 1 million square feet,
sir. And use 1 million hands.
But what about the opening of the filter factory tomorrow?
Then we cut the ribbon and tell them to start something else. Make them. What the heck is going on now?
Your problems may be over, General. We may not need the bomb after all.
Will today be a beautiful day for your